Hey everyone! Today, we're going to be recreating this artwork by Nicholas Mowgli. I really love this artwork. It's just something about it. It's like just this Alan Wake vibe it has to it. I've been really wanting to recreate it for a while. So today, we're going to be doing it. Disclaimer, right before we start, this video is not really supposed to be a tutorial. I'd rather leave that to the professionals. This is more like supposed to be a breakdown of an artwork. So we have Blender right here, and I'm just gonna delete the basic cube, and I'm just gonna put in a plane. So I'm just gonna put in a basic humanoid character. It just comes with the human gen add-on if you have it. It's nothing special, you can just have any model. I'm just gonna subdivide the cube so that I can place a displace modifier on it, and I'm just gonna reduce the strength of the displace modifier and just check off the floor so that it doesn't like slip through the plane all the time. Then I'm just gonna go into edit mode, mask out the area I want so that that area is flat and the rest is bumpy, so that I can have a proper road going through there, because roads generally are not supposed to be bumpy. So I just have this basic plane. I create a basic curve, and I'm just gonna extrude the curve along the area I wanted to go through, and then I'm just gonna take it off to the back. Then I just duplicated the plane at the back as well, just increase the scale of it, and now I am starting to create the house. So it's just a basic, I just start with a basic cube, just starting a block out, nothing complex, just starting out with a basic shape. I created the cube, then now I'm creating the roof. Just give it a basic solidify modifier. Then I started with the windows, and I'm just gonna put a cube down so that I can use that as a boolean and create a hole. And then I'm just gonna boolean into that boolean so I can have a window. And then I'm just gonna bevel the insides quite a lot, and then just give them a custom curve so that they just have a somewhat interesting inside, and then just give them a basic bevel on the outskirts so they just catch like a bit of rim light. If they do, it just gives a nicer overall look, because it just makes them a little less sharp, which is generally better for realism. And I'm just gonna start putting the frames and the boolean down. Then I'm just starting with the front porch. Again, just keep the shape simple. Just start with a basic cube and then start putting small little details as you go. Now I'm just starting to create the stairs. You don't need anything complex. You can literally just use the Archimish modifier that comes free with Blender, that like I just did. Like, stairs are just very simple. You don't have to waste time on them by like custom making every single step or something like that. I've seen some people try to do that. Nobody really notices, so there's not really too much of a point, unless they're like extremely stylized or something, then obviously you do, but otherwise there's not really a big point. And then I start with a curve, and this curve I'm just gonna use as a pipe, like in the artwork. I'm not that familiar with American homes, but I would assume that is a pipe that collects water and brings it down. And then this one is not supposed to be a pipe, it's supposed to be a cable. It's kind of supposed to be an electrical cable as far as I could make out. And it was coming from the top. I'm not really sure about the exact mechanics of that, but yeah. Then I used this geometry notes setup by Blender SE. I'm not sure how to pronounce it exactly, but they just have this free asset that you can use, and I mean you can do it by hand as well. It's not that hard to do, but there's no point in doing things that are like just a very small part of the scene. Now I'm just duplicating the homes, that one is supposed to be a barn, so I'm not copying any of the booleans. Then I realized that I made a mistake with the home, so I just copied it again. I forgot to copy the booleans. Then just modifying the shape of it a little bit, because it's supposed to be a little bit different. Like, the front porch is supposed to be a little bit higher, and there's not supposed to be two windows. So I just added one window because, I don't know, it just feels a little more natural to me to have at least a window. So now I'm starting with the big billboard that's like taking up like half the frame of the artwork, and just gonna do some very basic modeling, nothing complicated. And then I'm just gonna use the botanic modifier for just spawning in some trees in the background. And that's just good enough. Then I'm just gonna do some lighting. The mood of the artwork is like the most important part of it. Even if you have like basic assets, the mood can really, really just make it stand out. So I'm just gonna create a very basic volume setup. You can copy mine. It's just supposed to be a tiny bit better than the just putting in the standard volume scatter. Just like, it's a little bit brighter, I guess. It like doesn't become completely dark on the inside like it does normally. And then just setting up the mood a bit further, making the shadows much softer, then putting an area light at the top so that there's a little bit more focus on the central part and not the foreground or the background, because that's where the eye of the viewer is supposed to be. Then just creating a light blocker. That does a lot for the image, honestly. If you see, if I turn it off and on, it like adds so much mood to the scene. So I would totally recommend doing that to a lot of scenes generally. Then I'm just gonna merge the road that I arrayed. Otherwise, it's gonna be a nightmare to unwrap and stuff. So I merged them, unwrapped it, used the basic UV squares add-on. Then I just went to Fab, I guess it is now, and just downloaded a few materials. I mean, I'm still gonna call it Megascan, so I'm too used to that. Yeah, I just unwrapped a plane and then just UV'd them on top of it. Then I'm just playing with the roughness a little, because otherwise it just looks a little too bland. Then I'm just getting a few decals just to give a little bit of a breakup in the roughness and the color. Otherwise, it just looks too plain and CGI. Makes the road look way, way better. Then I'm just going to play with the alpha of the decals as well. If you just reduce them a little, like put them at like 0.5 alpha or something, they just kind of blend better. Then I started with using the Megascan grass, but after using it for a little, I realized that Blender does not like alpha grass at all. Like, not in the slightest. Like, you could throw like a million polygons worth of grass at it and it'll probably perform better than a grass that's just all alpha for some reason. That's at least for my PC, I'm not sure. I tried two different assets and both of them, because they were so heavy on the alpha, just started chugging the scene. Like, it was terrible. So then I just went with basic hand model grass from the Bagapai add-on. At least it looks hand modeled, and I made sure that it doesn't have much alpha to it, and it performed like almost perfect. Like, I did not notice any issues. Here, just masking out the grass a little bit. It was kind of clipping into the road, and you do not want that at all. It looks terrible. So just masking that out a little. Then I'm just playing with the values that the GeoScatter add-on provides. And the add-on is completely free. You can use the add-on. It's far better than like the basic tools that Blender provides for scattering, especially foliage. Then I start with like the roof texture. All of these textures are from Megascans. You can find them. Then I started with adding some lights into the scene. You don't need that much detail inside. I'm just adding the curtain with a basic translucent shader on top of it, and it does the job. The shader looks fine. Then just using an image for the kitchen on the inside. Then again, I'm just playing with the breakup of the grass a little. If it's completely the same amount of long everywhere, it just looks a little bad. So giving it a little bit of a breakup, some short grass patches somewhere, some bigger grass patches somewhere, it just makes it look. Definitely recommend giving that a try. Then just doing a little bit of a test render of how it's coming along. It's coming along okay. It needs a lot of work. Just adding a little bit effects in the compositor, but it doesn't really show up most of it. Then I just start with placing more foliage around in the scene, just getting a little nicer silhouette, and making sure to place some cover on the ground as well. Otherwise, there would be light leaking on the bottom and it would be dark on the top, and that just looks very unnatural. So make sure you have something blocking the light from getting in the back as well of the scene. Now I'm just creating a little bit of an offshoot path, just the dirt patches that we talked about. I decided to use an image texture instead, because vertex is, if you don't have like a million polygons on the plane, it just looks a little too low poly, I guess. So this works out much better and it's much cheaper on your hardware as well. Then here I'm just using the same mask that I created and then just plugging it into its values. After that, I start creating the lights you see on the streets. And for that, we can just take a very basic cube and just do a little bit of an extrude on the inside. Give it a sub D, and it looks good enough for the use that we have for it, because it's like very far in the back. You can barely make out it's even there. So it does the job. Then I'm just going to create a plane and just give it a very basic rough shape, see how it would look as a hill, and then just go in the sculpt mode and give it a more of a natural sculpt. From the camera angle, it just has to look decent from the specific camera angle that we need it for. After that, gotta take one of the trees that fits it the best and then just use it to scatter. After that, just pushing the volume a little back to the front and just changing the locations a little bit, moving things around a little to fit the composition better. And now here I just decided to give the back silhouette a little bit more of an interesting shape. So I just used the other tree. Then I start with the lighting a little more. So starting to place down the street lights. You can just use a basic spotlight for street lights. Just give it a higher value, make it a little bit more yellow. I still like the vibe that older towns have yellower lights compared to cities. It just looks a little nicer in my opinion. White lights just kind of look very bland. Something I would really recommend is put in an IES light instead of just the basic spotlight. It adds a little bit of a nicer gradient to your image. It just looks better overall. So I would recommend you can just use the IES library. It's a completely free website that you can use. I placed a very placeholder-esque pickup truck. It's like brand new. It doesn't even fit in the scene. It's just supposed to be a placeholder. Then I decided to put the kitchen into the back house as well. Then I started texturing the garage, just using an image texture you can find. Again, just place the... Oops, that's a lot. But I just placed the same placeholder truck in the back, gave it its basic headlights. I realized they were a little too strong. The IES lights tend to be a little strong at times. Much better. Then I just used a basic fence geometry node setup from the Bag of Pie add-on. And now just all this about changing the values to get the exact result you want with the fence. It's very customizable, so it's pretty good to get a lot of versatility in your fences and your results. After that, I'm very unhappy with how the car looks. It's completely deleted off of the scene. And then get one of the older models that I just had from previous projects and decide to use that. I just gave it a very basic texture and decided to use that instead. It just looks so much better. It's more old. It has that more of a 90s old town pickup truck vibe, which definitely fits the scene a lot more. Then just placing a little bit of then I'm texturing the billboard here, just another fab asset, and then I'm just using the color ramp. I don't want it to be that rusty, so I use the color ramp to make it more white instead, and just have a little bit of rust in there. Then I subdivide it and then use a few of the squares and use them as more of the rusty spots, like how they are in the artwork. I really like the way the billboard and the artwork looks. So I decided to also give it those little darker squares inside of it, and then just playing with how it looks. Then I just got a few barrels and scatter them around in the scene, otherwise it just looks dead. So you need a little bit more just human stuff that humans would generally need or interact with in the environment to make it look better and more natural. Then I just placed another old car that I had. It just fits the scene much better. Another old 90s-esque old town car. It just fits the aesthetic. I'm not gonna change the back car, honestly, because you can't really see it, so it's okay. It looks fine. Then just messing around with the textures a little. Then I decide in the end to place a few more bushes, because even though the reference that we're using doesn't have that many bushes, I don't think it has any at all. It just gives a little bit more of an interesting vibe in the scene. Then just using more of the trees. Then just seeing how much of a difference the front plane makes. It makes all the difference, honestly. The mood just completely shifts. And then just messing around with the settings before doing the final render to see how the scene is coming along. Then just placing some fog planes, using the fog planes add-on. You can just do them by hand, find some PNG textures of clouds. This one is just there, so you don't have to do the effort of finding them, I guess, but it's pretty much the same thing. It's not that different. It just makes it easier. Then I placed another area light. I noticed that there was not that much light coming from the top, and I'd like more of a gradient from lighter to darker. I mean, that's too much, obviously, so I turned it down. And then I'm just placing a few of them around to highlight a little bit more of the homes. Otherwise, the scene just becomes too muddy without a central focal point, or maybe, I guess, two central focal points here, because I'd like the focus to be both of the homes. And then I decided that the roof here looks way too, just, I don't know, artificial. So I had to give it a little bit more breakup. I hand painted a little bit of the textures there. And using that mask, I changed the roughness and the hue of the colors a little bit. And I'm doing the same for the other home. And honestly, that makes a huge difference. That makes it look so much more natural. Then I'm doing the same for the wooden part, just making it darker around the top, maybe from like the rain and the grime that's built up. Then just doing another test render to see if I'm missing something. Maybe there's need to be changes or something. I totally recommend doing just some renders, like not even just turn the viewport to render mode, just do a full render, because it just gives you some time to just think and see how the scene is coming along and maybe if you do need changes. And for me, I didn't think that I do need any changes at all. So I just decided to take it into DaVinci to do some post-processing. I would heavily recommend doing post-processing even on a still image that you're doing in Blender. I notice a lot of people who start just completely disregard it, but I think it makes all the difference in your scene. Like, it can take your scene from looking very basic without that much character to like just a very interesting and a far moodier scene. The lighting, you can mess around with the lighting, you can mess around with colors, you can change the whole vibe of how your scene looks. So I would heavily recommend trying that out. Like, you can already see here, like, I'm changing quite a lot about the colors of the scene here. And after the post-processing, we are finished. And that's how the final turned out. I hope you guys enjoyed the breakdown, and I'll try to do more in the future. Thank you for watching.